So what's going on, family? This is Monday morning. We are going to get in a truck, pickup truck, to pick up in, I think it's Decatur. We got to pick up in Decatur, I think, and going to Florida. Going to Orlando, Florida. So hopefully, I'm going to try to get up with Coyote Car Guys, and maybe we can meet him because I think he's out there in Florida, somewhere in Florida, I think close to Orlando. So maybe we get a chance to meet him and vlog with him. So we'll see y'all in the big truck. We have made it to the truck. This is a new trailer I picked up last week when I made the first trip with Crimson Truck Fried. And they put these big signs on here. The company, I think it looks pretty nice. Where the red trans line is, I think that I'm going to try to get them to give me the red one on the bottom on the door and change that to red too and make the smoke kind of red too. Kind of match up with my Crimson Tide A and stuff. So let's get in here, let's get started. What a beautiful day. We got to get our log started, and then we got to run and get some coffee and our fuel, which is our fuel for us is the coffee and the fuel to go in the truck. So we will see y'all when we get to the truck stop. Y'all know what time it is. Y'all know what time it is. It's that fuel time. Anybody want to help donate to this fuel bill? You can. I don't mind. I'll put a site up so you can help send a donation. But fuel today is $3.19, so that ain't bad. And that's over here in Birmingham. So let's get started. There's some high dollar stuff right here. And we're going to fill it up. So if any of y'all want to make a donation, you're welcome to. If I can get this thing started. Alright. Yeah, we take all donations. All donations to help with this truck. The highest bill is the fuel bill, so don't nobody mind helping. You can donate. I take pennies, nickels, dimes. If you want to donate all that, they all add up to be money. So just make sure you roll it up though. Alright, let's get this fuel thing started. I'm gonna raise the hood and check some stuff. So give me a minute. Let me set this camera down. Y'all just hold on right there. Watch this. I'm gonna try to get the camera over here. So a good spot so y'all can see what's going on. It holds up right there. I wish I had a stand. Might lay right there and might be fine. Okay, that'll, That'll work if it stays still. Think that'll work. Gotta get some paper towels, so hold on, y'all. Checking the stick, wipe it off, stick it back in there. It's a little bit over, y'all, but that's fine because I put some, I'm gonna check it one more time. I put some Lucas in it when I first had all that work done, so it's over a little bit, so that's fine. I'm gonna go over here, check our belts and everything, check the water. Water's up here looking fine, so it's on the max. Belts looking tight, both belts. Everything looking good. Don't see no leaks anywhere. Pretty much it. Other than that, we're gonna finish filling and we'll get back with you when we get back in the truck. Okay, y'all, we made it back in. We pulled up fuel. We got our coffee, our fuel. We went back and got our old cup from home, which got the Alabama thing on it. And I like this cup better because it keeps it warmer. Keeps it warmer longer and everything. So let's start our trip. Some of y'all that don't know, I got on a scale and I forgot to show y'all I'm getting on scale, but I'm gonna show y'all weight ticket. This is the weight ticket. This lets you know if you're overweight or not. Like on my steers, I got 11,700. Hold on 1 minute. I'll cut this air down soon. Okay, on my steers, I got 11,700. On my drives axle, I got 30,300, and on my trail, I got 31,460 as a gross, total weight of 73,460. That's good. On your steers, you can only have 1,200. On your drives, you can have 34 on the axle and 34 axle on your trailer, and your max gross can only be 80,000 unless you're pulling overweight loads, which you got to have an overweight permit. But this, for some of y'all that don't know anything about scales, this is how we have to weigh our loads, so keep the DOT off our back and make sure that we legal. So other than that, we're gonna get started on this trip. We're good on weight, good on fuel, and we got to ride because we got to push it to Florida. We got a long ways to go. We got 652 miles, and it's saying we're gonna get there at 12:55, and I gotta be there by 3 o'clock. Of course, I'm gonna stop a couple more times but I have no time to play around, so let's hit the road. Y'all know we weighed our load early in the day, so we fine. So we got the green light. Of course, we knew we were gonna get the green light unless they wanted to pull us to the side and check our paperwork and stuff. They would have said pull over or show the arrow. Some of them had the arrow, some of them just tell you to pull over on the mic. So we was good. So we getting back on Interstate 75. And 3 miles, we got the agriculture inspection, where a lot of times they ask you what you got, and if you got, like, you pulling a reefer unit or something, and you got, like, pulling the fruits and vegetables, they want to make a copy of your paperwork, just in case something happened, when you're taking that fruit stuff, they can trace back where it came from. So, when I used to pull reefer units, I pull dry van now, when I used to pull reefer units, they used to run and get produce and stuff out of Florida and take it up to the 5 boroughs, like the Bronx and Brooklyn and Philly and all that. They used to always make a copy of the paperwork so they can always trace back where the fruit and vegetables came from, you know, what state it came out of. So I always had to deal with them. Most of the time, like I said, they either wait and buy if you got a dry van, or they just ask you what you got. So we're gonna leave the cameras rolling, and we're gonna let y'all see what it's like to go into agriculture inspection. So let's get a little music playing till we get there. We got 3 miles. Made it here to McLean's, but as y'all can see, it's a doggone mess out here. All these trucks, everybody got the same appointment, which is really ridiculous. Everybody got the same appointment, so my appointment is at 3:30. By the time I get in there, it's gonna be 4 o'clock. But this is ridiculous. Everybody got the same appointment, and we get this done to us all the time. Well, you have probably 15, 20 trucks coming in with the same appointment. This is crazy. We're going to try to walk up here and check in. This is what you had to deal with in Florida, rush hour traffic. Man, this is worse than Atlanta. And this is Orlando and Tampa traffic. So, ain't no better here than being in Atlanta. Bumper to bumper traffic, afternoon rush hour traffic. So, this is ridiculous. For those y'all that live here in Orlando or close to Tampa, I throw my hats off to y'all deal with this every day. All right, we'll see y'all later when we get the load. Okay, family, what we got here is a trailer right here, a dump trailer. And what happened is our trailer went down. We got a problem with when it was pulling to one side, dog legging, and we had to leave our trailer in Florida. Had to leave our trailer in Florida and then turn around and pull this one to North Carolina. It's a dump bucket. So we got to pull that. And this way it looked like hooked up the Crimson Truck Pride. Big gap right there. But like I said, family, what we got to do is pull this trailer to North Carolina. Our trailer is down. Pull a couple of other trailers till ours get fixed, which will be sometime next week. So we're going to go ahead and fix it, take y'all on a ride. Let's get it.
Turn left.
Got too many plugs to start. You ain't watching the plugs. What time is it now? You want me to wait till after 8:30? Okay. How long does it take you to do that? Okay.
So, fam, did you see that place over there, Annie Market Cafe? That's a place that I used to eat when I stayed in Dunn all the time. Me and my friends used to get up on the weekends or some during the weekday and eat there. I'm here to go to meet my second mama. We're going to go eat breakfast this morning. So, I'm treating her out to breakfast. I haven't seen her in a couple years. So, it's good to come meet her here, eat at a good place. So hopefully food is still the same and good as it used to be. But other than that, y'all, we'll see y'all when we get back on the road. So we have delivered this trailer in Goldsboro, and we're fixing to unhook from it. And we're fixing to go on to our next trip, so we'll see you there. Okay, family, we done got our next trailer, and we got a tanker. First time ever putting a dry tanker. So we got this in Virginia, in Danville, Virginia, and we got to take this all the way to Illinois. Somewhere in Illinois, I don't forget. But anyway, so here's your Crimson Truck Pride up under the tanker for the first time. So get pull back and get y'all get a good view. So I wonder what this gonna feel like. And it's got single tires on it. So, all right, let's get ready to ride. ride group. We at the truck stop. We're gonna end this. We're gonna end this vlog with a walk around. We do have an Avery trailer that we're taking to Atlanta. So all this week we've basically been hauling. See, that's the Avery trailer hooked up to Crimson Truck Pride. We have hauled all different kinds of trailers. All different kinds of trailers this week. From tankers, the containers, the vans, to dump buckets. So we done hauled them all. So with that said, we're gonna end this week, and we're gonna end with a good cup of coffee, fresh coffee that we went and got. And that's gonna be the end of this vlog this week with Crimson Truck Pride 2. So I hope y'all enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And also hit that notification bell so whenever I post, y'all can see when I post and give you an indication. So with that said, y'all have a good one. This is your boy. I'm out of here. Peace. Roll Tide Roll, baby. For life.